Does your Windows PC keep booting into BIOS? Then you are at the right place, as we have the solutions for you to fix this issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. If your Windows PC keeps booting into BIOS, the solutions provided in this video should help you. This issue prevents you from using your computer because you will see the BIOS screen every time you turn it on. There can be many reasons why your PC keeps restarting in BIOS, such as incorrect boot sequence, damaged SATA cable, loose SATA cable connection, misconfigured BIOS settings, a faulty hard drive, etc. Now, let's get started on how to fix the issue. Method 1. Check your boot sequence. This is the first thing you should do. Follow this guide to check the boot sequence in your BIOS and ensure you have selected the correct hard drive. If your BIOS doesn't detect your hard drive, it may have been damaged. However, we suggest you try all other fixes before jumping to the conclusion. Method 2. Reseat RAM. The next step is to reseat RAM. First, turn off your computer properly. Then turn off the switch and disconnect the power cable to avoid electric shock. Now, open the computer case and gently remove the RAM sticks from the memory slots. Clean them and reinsert them. Check if it works. If you have more than one RAM stick, insert them in different memory slots or one at a time. If you're not confident enough to perform this, you can get professional help. Method 3. Disconnect all other hard drives. Disconnect all the other hard drives other than the hard drive on which the operating system is installed. After doing that, boot your PC and see what happens. If there is any problem with your boot drive, the issue will reappear again. Method 4. Check the connections of the SATA cable. SATA cable is used to connect the storage devices, such as hard drives, to the computer motherboard. If the SATA cable is faulty or there is a loose connection, the hard drive remains undetected and the user will experience boot issues if the hard drive is the boot drive. If you have cleaned your computer, it is possible that the cable is not connected properly. Check the SATA cable connection. Disconnect the cable and reconnect it. If your PC motherboard has more than one SATA port, connect the SATA cable in each port and see if it works. Your SATA cable may also need to be fixed. If your system has multiple hard drives, you can check this by connecting the other hard drive with the same SATA cable. Method 5. Disable fast boot in BIOS. BIOS of some computers has an option to enable and disable the fast boot. You can check this in your BIOS settings. So you should go through the user manual to know the exact process or visit the manufacturer's website. Once you are in the BIOS settings, check if there is any option to enable or disable the fast boot in your PC BIOS settings. If available, disable the fast boot. Save the settings and restart your computer. Method 6. Check the status of the SATA controller in BIOS. The SATA controller modes in BIOS determine how a hard drive communicates with the computer. If you turn off or disable this feature, your hard drive will not be detected by Windows OS. You can check this setting in your BIOS. If this option is disabled, enable it. You have to refer to the official website of your computer manufacturer to know how to access the settings in your BIOS. Method 7. Reset BIOS. Modifying the BIOS settings can sometimes cause issues. Therefore, you should not try this if you are unsure what to do. If you have made any changes to your BIOS settings after which the issue started occurring, resetting the BIOS settings to default will fix it. Method 8. reset CMOS or replace the CMOS battery. A dead CMOS battery can cause various issues on a computer. If you have a digital multimeter, you can check the output voltage of the CMOS battery installed on your computer. First, follow this link to reset CMOS and see if it helps. To do so, remove the CMOS battery and reinstall it. If this doesn't work, install a new CMOS battery. One indication of a dead CMOS battery is the incorrect date and time. Method 9. Update or flash BIOS. Updating your BIOS to the latest version can also fix this issue. You can follow this link to update BIOS. Because you cannot boot into your computer, you should use the flash BIOS method to update it to the latest version. Refer to the official website of your computer manufacturer to learn the exact method for flashing your computer BIOS. You need to download the latest version of the BIOS from the official website. While flashing the BIOS, ensure your computer receives a continuous power supply. Interrupting the power supply while flashing the BIOS will break your motherboard and may cause permanent boot failure. Method 10. Your hard drive might be faulty. If none of the solutions worked for you, the possibility of a faulty hard drive is high. Now, fixing this issue is out of your scope. Therefore, we suggest you contact a professional computer repair technician for further assistance. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.